Hello, how you going? Are you well? Thanks a million for coming out tonight. Isn't it lovely? Yes. So this ostensibly is supposed to be my 20th anniversary in Glasgow. I actually got it wrong. It's actually my 19th. I lied to Donald to get the gig. But I'm delighted to be here. It's great. So we're going to start, we're going to do a lot of new songs, and depending on how ye applaud, we'll decide then if they get on the new album. So you have to really cheer very loudly. So the first one is actually a Cork song that I got from Jimmy Crowley, and it's called Doll in Cash's Window.
Johnny walking, I'll take him up the dive. I'll take Johnny walking, I'll dress him in blue and white. He was the doll with the T-doll arrow. He was the boy with the curly hair. He was the doll that catches window. No, but I am my Johnny. Your daddy is a sailor.
Thanks very much. Well, I'm joined here by a group of fantastic people who've been very good to me over the past 19 years. This is the wonderful Mike McGoldrick on whistles. Niall Vallely on the concertinas and whistles. Dirk Powell on the fiddle, the banjos, accordion. There's Sean O'Graham here on the guitars. James McIntosh on the drums. Ewan Vernal on bass. And Donald Shaw on the piano. So it's great to be here with everyone. They've been minding me for years, and it's great to be back here doing a gig with these men. We're going to bring a great singer out now, and she's a beautiful young woman, really feisty, great political head on her, and she just got married actually to Sean Oak 4 weeks ago. We were at their wedding. It was amazing. It was like a festival. Four men and a dog headlined at their wedding. So please make welcome Niamh Dunn.
He said, hold on, hold on, please hold on.
Anyway.
Chameleon. Well, we're going to do another new song called... actually, I don't really know what it's called yet. And it's another love song. Maybe it'll be called Blackbirds, but I think there's so many songs called that, it probably won't be. So I'd also like to welcome another great young singer, beautiful woman who's, actually she'll be singing in the second half with Atlantic Arc. Could you please make welcome Pauline Scanlon. Thanks a million. So I wrote this song for my mother, and it's called Lovely Annie. And my mother was very good to me. She was an amazing woman and helped me through an awful lot in my life. And I miss her every day still. But I suppose I have her in a lot of my own character and spirit. And she was a really great woman. And she helped me immensely, especially being on tour earlier. She did a lot of support for me, and she also minded my children. So I miss her dearly. I have a teenager now, so I'm constantly looking for advice on what to do with the teenager. If you have any, you can let me know. Okay, here we go. It's called Lovely Annie.
Sing for you, a lullaby, a lullaby, a lullaby.
Thank you. Thanks a million. I was singing that last year in the concert hall in Dublin, and I had invited my two aunts actually to come to the gig, you know, because it was a big deal. And I was on the radio and I dedicated the song to them, I said, for my auntie Una and Maura, who are my mother and sister. And there wasn't a peep from the audience, and they never came. They're desperate. And I know I love them dearly, so I rang them afterwards. I said, why didn't you come to the gig? And they said, oh, well, we were watching The Voice. The irony, I don't know why I try. Anyway, we're going to do a really great song that was written by Ian Sinclair, one of your own. And it's a beautiful Scottish song that I've been singing for years. It's called The King's Shilling. And it's an anti-war song. And I mean, I know in Scotland, as well as ourselves, we have a great line of Gaelic tradition and defiance. And we, you know, very similar sensibilities after our dispossession and colonialism. And so I kind of take a lot of Scottish songs and steal them, and then I sing them in an Irish accent, and I tell everyone in America that actually they're Irish. So we are very similar, aren't we, the Irish and the Scots? You're probably just a little bit more miserable than us. Just a tad. So, and this, it does, song speaks to that time-honoured tradition of speaking out against colonialism. I've been doing that for 20 years, and I think it has failed us greatly. I see colonialism, you know, worldwide today, but I also think of it as when one group of people wants to make another group of people feel small, or when one man, particularly your man now in the White House, wants to just, even I think if anybody feels small, even just one person, I think we've all failed humanity. So I think we need to really work hard to try and gather together in our shared humanity and protest. So this is my protest to the right. And I hope, would you like to sing along in that spirit of trust, yes, and protest? So, thank you. The chorus is very simple. It's, come laddies, come, hear the cannon roar. Take the king's shilling and you're off to war. Do you have it? It's like, it's your song.
Join the company and march to home. They fought and the men did fall. Cut down by bayonet and musket ball. Many of these brave young men would never fight for, they never fight for the king again.
Mike McGoldrick for bringing me to Glasgow. We were on tour in Ireland and we were going around the highways and byways of Ireland doing a network tour, and then we had a great time. And then the night before Mike was due to come to Glasgow, we stayed up all night, really. That was in the old days. Now I drink chamomile tea and everything. And he said he would want to come to Glasgow, so we were at the airport and the planes were going up and down, and Mike says, "Is this the B&B, Karen?" Anyway, I thought that was really funny, guys. Jesus, I'm trying. Okay, we're gonna do another new song and invite out a wonderful woman who has been a deep inspiration to myself as a person, and her singing is just sublime. You're blessed to have her in your presence. Would you please welcome the wonderful Karan Matheson.
Thank you.
So in our infinite wisdom, you know, we're going to sing a song that we don't quite know yet, but feck it, sure.
Well, it's great. Celtic connections, after all.
It's actually a love song I wrote with this great man here, Sean O'Graham. He's just a champion. He's just a great musician and a really quiet, strong, confident presence. So thank you, Sean O, for writing this. So wish us luck. Key? Oh, yeah. A flat. Okay, great.
Before you, I stand.
Yes, it's you. Thank you. I shouldn't have told you that we didn't know it. We did, didn't we? Okay, well, we're going to do another Cork song. I'm actually from Waterford, but I've lived in Cork this is my beautiful husband here, by the way, Niall Vallely. Yes. So I'll sing this for Niall. He's amazing to me, and he feels all the questions, and obviously I'm really easygoing and really easy to live with. So thank you very much, Vlad. This is Ger Wolfe's song, and he's a gas man. He lives in Cork, and it's called The Curra Road.
Down the coast.
Jackson. Okay, we're going to do a Bob Dylan song called Hollis Brown. And it's a great song. And it talks about poverty. Actually, I think a lot of the way the world is today is because of the crash in 2008 and because of greed. There are now, I think, 8 men in the world who own the same amount of money as 3.6 billion people. So I think that's crazy, and I need to, we think, to change the world and really get out there and start protesting. So we've got to the unapologetic political stage of the show. Donald in his grand piano. Are you one of the 8?
Yeah, sorry about that. Yeah.
Do you like his piano? That's because he's one of the 8.
Dirty
Celtic song, the shotgun that you're holding in your hand. Your eyes fix on the shotgun that you're holding in your hand. The seven breezes blowing all around the cabin door. So we're just going to do two more songs, but thank you all very much for coming out. It's been great to be back here. Please welcome, once again, Niamh Dunn. This is actually an American song written by a great woman called Eliza Gilkingson, and she's a fantastic songwriter. I'm big into American music. I have the great privilege here of having Dirk Powell all the way from Louisiana. Isn't he great? Dirk brought myself and Niall over to Louisiana, and we did a little tour. It was fantastic. And we had our little girl, Mirren, the teenager I was talking about earlier. She was two, and we were doing this interview thing, and I had her walking along a wall outside this lake, and next thing I looked and it said, "Don't allow small children or pets near the lake. Please mind the alligators." A poor child. Okay. So, anyway, that has absolutely nothing to do with this next song. Here we go.
Teachings of a man of God, man of God.
thanks very much. We're just going to do one more song. I want to thank Pauline Scanlon, Niamh Dunn, Karen Matheson, Donald Shaw for continually having faith in me. I'm nearly 50. Ewan Vernal. Woo! James McIntosh. Sean O'Graham. Dirk Powell. Niall Vallalee. And Mike McGoldrick. To have an orchestra for the 20th.
The place where you were living, in which your life and